Hi, this is Electronics. In this video, I will review the stereo digital Bluetooth amplifier. You can find the link to this circuit in the video description. This Bluetooth amplifier circuit has three connectors, one for the power and two for the stereo output. On the other side there's a micro USB connection. As you can see, it has a very small size, almost as small as my thumb. With the help of my digital caliper, I measure the size of the board. It is 20.52mm wide and 40.6mm long. Next, I connect my phone charger and power up the board. A bright blue LED indicates that it is on. Now I can search for the board with the phone. The name of the board is DW-CT14 Plus. The continuous light indicates that the pairing is successful. I start the function generator application and with the help of the cable included with the board, I connect the oscilloscope to the output. If you want to see the review of the oscilloscope, you can check it here or on the link in the description. The output signal is very distorted as you see, it should be a smooth sine wave, but instead a lot of small waves can be observed. The reason for this is that the amplifier circuit is made of a Class D amplifier, which output is made of high frequency pulse width modulation. This high frequency is higher than the audio frequency limit of the human hearing. Later I will show you how to get rid of the high frequency and how to recreate partially the original audio signal. In the next step I connect my speaker which I saved from a 2.1 audio system. This speaker has 8 ohm impedance, that means that it can have lower loudness than the 4 ohm speaker. In the description of this Bluetooth board on the website there wasn't specified what speaker impedance it can handle, which would be very important. In this video I will use 2 8 ohm speakers to test this board. I play a music and also connect the oscilloscope to see how the waveform looks. In the next step I connect the coil in series with the output. This coil is big but you can also make yourself a smaller one. After the coil I connect the capacitor in parallel with the speaker, taking care of the polarity. If the coil is smaller that means that it has less inductance and the value of the capacitor must be increased. The desired cutoff frequency is 20 kHz because higher than this is not audible for human beings. Now that the low pass filter is ready, I use my function generator app again to test it. This time the sine wave has a better shape with a few digits. This means that the filter circuit is working. I've tested the circuit to see if there is any audible difference using the filter, but there was no difference, except the visual one on the oscilloscope. Then the question comes, why is the filter necessary? The reason is that the woofer or subwoofer speakers do not support the high frequency sounds. On a longer period it can be harmful. I made a power supply using a 12 volts transformer and a 7805 voltage regulator to measure the current drawn by the board. The quiescent current drain is 43 milliamps, but as soon as I start to play music this value increases instantly. At maximum volume it averages about 200 milliamps, but it is hard to measure an exact value so I use again the function generator application. With a continuous tone at the maximum volume it drains about 440 milliamps. I tested the board also with 4 ohm speakers and obviously it was a lot louder. After playing music for a few minutes, the amplifier ICs got very hot, so a small heatsink would be recommended if you want to use it on a long term with 4 ohm speakers. The output power to a 4 ohm speaker is 1.5 watts and also the overall current drain is double, almost 1 amp. Next, I wanted to test what is the lowest voltage at which this board still works. Using my variable voltage supply, I went down to 3.2 volts when the board made a tone and turned off. This is a safety feature if a lithium-ion battery is used, so this protects the battery from over-discharge. The last test was the coverage distance. This small Bluetooth board's effective range is 6-7 meters, which is quite impressive. In conclusion, this small Bluetooth board is very good, with great sound and coverage distance. The circuit is designed to be used with lithium-ion battery, but I strongly recommend also using protection circuit with it. Thank you for watching. Leave a like if you want to see more videos like this one, and don't forget to subscribe.